On arrival in Kiruhura district today for the International Women's Day celebrations, President Museveni started the day with the launch of the National Science, Technology, Engineering and Innovation Center. The center is a training ground for innovations.
We come here today to let the world know and also let you know about the new thing we are launching together in partnership with the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, the Ministry of Education and Sports, and the Ministry of ICT. This is what we call the digital. This consists of 21 laptops, 21 computers and 21 smartphones with a screen engraved into it. It also has an air conditioner and it's powered with solar.
It's at this point that the president reiterated that there will be no budget cuts for science and technology, rather the sector will be prioritized.
This woman will not be a scientist, or you will not get many of them, you will get a few, but it is easier if the whole society comes up, gets out of non-money economy into money economy, then you will be able to get more scientists, both men and women.
The Minister for Science, Technology and Innovation, Dr. Monica Musenro, said they are to come up with similar innovation hubs across the country. After launching the Innovation Center, the President headed to Sanga Town Council grounds where the main function for the International Women's Day celebrations was held.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the Republic of Uganda, Your Excellency, you're welcome. On Women's Day,
therefore, Mama, it is your day.
Speaking to the gathering, he re-echoed how farming and agriculture remains key to the country's development. Museveni went ahead and showed several videos of progressive farmers giving testimonies of how agriculture and farming has transformed their lives.
Those are now the Wanyankore you are talking about. That's how they are living now, from the grass huts. And they have solar, they have water. If you just look at the horizon.
The president also cautioned families against land fragmentation, saying it's increasing rural poverty, food insecurity, and conflicts.
Stop fragmenting wealth when the head of the family dies. Share by emigabo, not physical fragmentation. Secondly, grow pasture and other foods like maize, sorghum for the cattle. Do not just depend on what nature prepares. Use nature to do better for your family and for Uganda.
He congratulated women towards reaching the International Women's Day, and dummy checks were issued to women groups from Kasese, Luengo, Yibanda, Kazo, Bushenyi, among others, to benefit from the Women Entrepreneurship Funds.
All Ugandans, stop excuses. It is possible to get out of poverty. The people in the cattle corridor had got out of poverty through the dairy industry guided by the NRM.
The State Minister for Lands, Housing and Urban Development, Persis Namganza, also issued over 400 land titles.
Your Excellency, we were supposed to hand over 1,481 land titles. However, we are requesting those who are not able to come here that you are going to receive these titles at our Ministerial Zone office in Imbarara.
The president also hailed the role of women in the country's development, promising to help them overcome lingering bottlenecks. He thus awarded 63 women for their outstanding service and loyalty to the country. Among the women awarded was the former minister Mary Karoro Okurut, nursing officers, civilians, UPDF officers, police officers, among others. This year's Women's Day celebrations have been held under the theme Equal Opportunities in Education, Science and Technology for Innovation and a Gender Equal Future. Report compiled by Juliet Namowaya for the news.